such a great conversation with this woman. I can't wait to introduce you to her. She's in our virtual green room as part of the Author's Corner. Tallulah Banks has written a book called Pigeon with a Bright View. Tallulah, thanks so much for joining us.
Sure, of course.
So first of all, let's talk about how long you've been writing and why you wrote this book.
Well, I've been writing probably since 2006. The reason that I wanted to, and my spirit churned to get this out there, is because I really have a heart for incarcerated women and homeless.
And that's why. And that's why you did that, right?
Yeah.
Because you wanted the world to know those stories. You and I talked about that.
Well, if just one person reads Pigeon with a Bright View and gains understanding or gets their healing, then it's all worth it.
Well, let's talk about your story and what happened to you, because that was also part of the impetus for you writing this. Tell the listeners about that.
Well, I was going through a bad divorce, and we had two small children, and I had an injunction on him. I dismissed it. Because the kids missed him, I was young and naive, and he immediately gets one on me. And unfortunately, whoever has the injunction on the other, the power and all the cards are in that person. So I've been to jail 7 times over trying to see my children.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's so powerful for you to talk about that and put that in this book. And I want to emphasize this because it's a beautiful book. And again, you can get it on Amazon, Pigeon with a Bright View. And it makes sense because of what we were just talking about, how you wanted to highlight homelessness and women incarcerated. And it happened to you. And when you went through that 7 different times, gosh, how gut-wrenching was that? How hard was that?
Oh, God. You know, every time I went to jail, it was always a little more time, you know, a few days more, a week more. And on the last time to jail, which was my 7th time, I spent 60 days in jail. But, you know, it's the hardest thing I've ever had to do. But honestly, it was the best thing that could have happened because you're trapped in a building. So you can either play Uno or you can examine your character and try to get rid of your muck and sludge. And peel back the layers and just hear the hard truth, you know?
Wow, I love that. Get rid of the muck and sludge. That is a what we call tweetable moment, actually. Because you're right, you were sitting there and you could feel sorry for yourself and it was hard and you missed your kids.
Yes.
And then you come out on the other side. So when you write this book, because this is in your head and you sit down and you finally write it, did that feel good to get it out there?
Well, yes, and how I was able, the Pigeon with a Bright View, I had given it to a lady, actually, that I was incarcerated with because she was a recovering prostitute crack addict. So I thought, how awesome for someone that was in jail with me to do a review. So she liked it a lot, so she gave it to her pastor, who was so moved by it. He sponsored 1,000 copies, which was like $4,500. I never met him. And so what I did is my goal is I want to get this into the jails, because when you can get a book into their little library, it doesn't move. It will never leave because you're not allowed as an inmate and you're free. You can't take anything that's the jail property. So I was able to get it in 22 states, a town in Bolivia and a town in India.
Wow. So the ultimate goal is to just get this everywhere
Yep.
so that you can give hope, really,
Exactly.
to so many of the women that are in prison.
Yeah. And the thing is, you know, when you're so broken and you've gone through so much loss, you know, bam, another loss, bam, another loss, bam. Even though it centers around being in jail, and some people might think, you know, kind of snobbly, like, well, then that's not for me, blah, 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 you know.
Right.
But everybody on this planet has been broken before to some level. And everybody on this planet has experienced loss. But here's the good thing about that. God says there's power in brokenness because you're humble, you have a willing spirit, you have a teachable spirit. You know, everything's on the table. And you can deal with the hard truth because you are so humble and you are so remorseful, you know?
Yeah, and you're right about that. So dealing with the hard truth and and being able to examine that. So now, like, I'm thinking about this and the power of Pigeon with a Bright View is, are you planning on doing a sequel?
Well, probably not, because I don't plan on going to jail ever again. But I've completed a short devotional guide for teenagers, and it's written like, I write like I'm actually having a conversation with you.
Right.
It's not stuffy. It's not cliche. It's not the same old thing that every other person is writing. I try to write where it's refreshing, you know?
Yeah.
Like, oh, wow, that's kind of neat. And, you know, and they'll be compelled to, I really want to read this.
Right.
And I just completed a children's book called The Land of Ish.
The Land of Ish. So tell us quickly about The Land of Ish, because you can't just leave us hanging.
Basically, it's about a girl and God. But how I worded it is the father, not a father, but the father. And he was like, well, what color do you want to make the sky? And what kind of animal should we put over here? And, oh, wow, Father, I see my face in the clouds. Thank you. And he goes, that's because I love you, and I wanted to show you how much I love you. So there's a nice flow to it.
Right. Yeah, it sounds like it. So, again, we tell everybody you can pick up Pigeon with a View, Tallulah Banks. That's who we're speaking with on Amazon. Ultimately, and I think we've heard that throughout this conversation, but what do you hope people really ultimately take away from reading your book?
Yeah, well, the whole key is to be relatable to all kinds of people, atheists, agnostics, Baptists, whatever. But I want to go further in this because I know that there's power in it, and I say that humbly. And all the feedback that I've gotten from people is more than positive. Like, I was so touched. We use this in the men's devotion and a lot of things like that. But my goal is to reach the masses, you know. I don't want to stop with, you know, a few hundred or a few thousand people. I want to sell 200 million copies, and not because it's greedy or, ooh, I'll get rich. It's like, if you can reach the masses, now we're talking huge impact.
Wow, I love that. So that's the vision. So your vision is even bigger than that. You're right. It's like somebody told me one time, Tallulah, if you have the passion and you have the vision, of course, money would follow. That's just our scorecard.
Yeah, but it's a byproduct.
It's a byproduct. But what you would do is help people, because there are so many people, you said it, that they might not have gone to prison, but they're suffering some kind of loss, and they are in their own different cages, don't you think?
Absolutely. And there's people out there, oh, I believe in God. Okay, I invited Jesus into my heart when I was in second grade. But there's a lot of people that will never step foot in a church because they've been hurt. They've been judged, the hypocrisy. And that's my whole point. It's just about the love of God. It's not shoving, oh, Jesus loves you, I'll pray for you, you know, which does absolutely nothing.
Right.
And so just touching people on every aspect, because people that have a hard heart, like, I'm not going to church, there's nothing wrong with me, that kind of thing, just prideful, hard heart, I think when they get to that level, sincerely, the only way to prick a pinpoint in them is through moving music or humor.
Yeah, boy, isn't that true. Mm-hmm. I completely agree with you. I love your broader vision and the way you see the world, and wow, 7 times in jail, and see, you're the example of, it doesn't mean your life is over, this is what you do, and that's part of this too, don't you think?
Yeah, you bounce back.
you bounce back, because it would be very easy, and many people do this, to feel sorry for them, for yourself, in whatever situation you're in.
Sure.
And that's what your book is about. Your book is so aptly titled, Pigeon with a Bright View. So this is the reason why you should pick this up, because it really is raw and telling and a wonderful, wonderful read. Tallulah Banks, thanks so much for joining us on the show.
Oh, you're so welcome. Thank you for having me.